The Atlanta Falcons might have gotten a great receiving talent in Kyle Pitts, but now they're losing a great receiving talent in Julio Jones. Recently on Undisputed, Julio Jones basically confirmed everything to Shannon Sharp on the phone. We don't know if he knew he was on air, but he told us, I'm out of there. I'm out of Atlanta. What are our reactions to this, and where do we think is the best landing spot for Julio Jones in the NFL? I'll start with you, Darren.
My reaction to this is, you know, extreme excitement. I've hated Julio Jones since for about 15 years now.
Hated?
Hated the man. You got to understand, he went to Alabama, then he went to the Falcons, and he just couldn't have had a worse course for his career. So if he's leaving the two teams that I hate the most on each level, then I'm ecstatic. The guy's a phenomenal talent. I have different feelings about Cam Newton now that he's out of the division. So yes, I've had bad emotions towards Julio Jones for about 15 years almost. So yeah, I'm feeling pretty good about it. But if we're talking about where he could go, there's two teams that I think he should go to. Unfortunately, I don't think he'll go to either. And I'll start off with the Indianapolis Colts. I think he should go to the Colts because yes, they have Michael Pitt. And he needs some time to grow, but I think he's a good player. Yes, they have T.Y. Hilton, but I'm not sure how much he has left in the tank. And yes, they have Paris Campbell, but he just can't stay healthy. So they have an interesting wide receiver room. They have a new quarterback. They have a great offensive line, a great defense, a really good running game. But then they just need that one stud wide receiver, and that division is theirs. That division is very much so for the taking between them and the Titans. I think Julio Jones wants to go somewhere he can win. He might not put up 1,400 yards. That might not be the type of system that they're going to have. However, all those yards will be meaningful. They won't be garbage time yards. They won't be fighting for wins and end up losing in the end. They won't have an onside kick that they couldn't recover. They won't – sorry. Start bashing on the Falcons. Give me a second. Let me bring it back. They won't have any of those things, but he will be in a successful team. Unfortunately, they have a conditional second-round pick already traded for Carson Wentz. So we're not sure if it'll be a second or a first. You can't really trade either one of them without knowing the compensation. So unless they just decide, hey, I'll give this first to the Eagles for sure and use this second to get Julio, otherwise I don't think it happens. And my other team is the Packers. I think this is a perfect solution. And I know we're going to talk about them later, but give them Jordan Love. They have their young quarterback, because I think they should have drafted a quarterback, especially if you have to trade Julio Jones. You're starting over anyway. Matt Ryan is older, which is the reason that they thought a quarterback should have been selected, a lot of people. So give them a young quarterback. They have their weapon in Pitts to go with Calvin Ridley. You give Green Bay a nice – they'll have the best receiver duo in the league with that. Keep Aaron Rodgers happy, and he's going to a winner, which is what he said. He says he wants to win. Why not go to the team that's been in the NFC Championship back-to-back years? Unfortunately, it's in the NFC, and I'm sure they're trying to get Julio out of that conference.
So Julio said he wants to go to a winner. And among that list of teams on his teams of interest was the New England Patriots. And I feel like a lot of great players, once they hit that back end of their career, that's where a lot of them go. However, the Patriots are in a stage of rebuilding. But Bill Belichick is not one to be underestimated. I feel like the Patriots would be a good fit for Julio, and they're in a position to where they can afford Julio. After that, it will come down to Cam Newton, who only had eight touchdown passes last season. So you throw Julio into the mix with the other young receivers that they pulled in this past offseason, and he elevates your offense. Again, it will come down to Cam Newton's ability to pass the ball more. If not, then they have Mac Jones as a backup quarterback, who I'm pretty sure Bill Belichick is going to do due diligence in grooming to be a quarterback for this level. So I wouldn't count out Julio going to the Patriots right now. And I think they can afford him, and he would look nice in that offense.
I look at Julio Jones at this point of his career, and I don't think he should go anywhere where he is needed. I think he's a nice cherry on top, or a nice, really, really nice side. I don't think he should go anywhere where he's going to be the number one receiver, because it's just, as we can see for the past 2 years, he hasn't been healthy. He hasn't been available for the whole season. And I don't think any team that needs a receiver should really look to Julio to be that, because then you're going to be kind of wishing upon a star. I think he should go somewhere like the Titans. The Titans just lost Corey Davis, their number two receiver, but they still have A.J. Brown, who, in fact, idolizes Julio Jones, wore his jersey pregame last year a couple of times. Like, it, I think it's the perfect spot. It's a machine where the offense is running. You know what I'm saying? It's like Tannehill is a system quarterback, and it's a machine. It has nothing to do with it, – it's just an offensive machine with Derrick Henry and A.J. Brown. It's a machine. You plop him there, he's extra. He's not needed there. And I think that's where it's going to be very useful for Julio to go, because he knows that's where they're going to be successful. If he goes somewhere else, they're going to be looking to him to be successful. If you want to go to a winner, you need to go somewhere where they don't need you, where you can only make them better. And I think the Titans are the perfect place for that. But Do we have that?
Two things. One, Julio has not been as hurt as I feel like the narrative tries to spin. He played a lot of games last year. I think he played 14 plus. I think maybe even 15 games last year. So he wasn't hurt.
Well, not but how many games was he like 50% before, though? Like, I feel like I saw so many games.
He's never 100% in a season, man. Yeah, he's getting older, but I think he can still, and I think he is quite possibly a top five receiver. I don't think it's crazy to say that. I would put him in my top five. So I don't think it's fair to put him in the, he needs to be the cherry on top. I think very much so he could go to a Indianapolis, like I said, and be the number one in hopes that Carson Wentz. And you made the same reaction you did when I said it the first time. Speak your mind, brother Root. What's going on?
The same reaction to what? Are you talking about Indianapolis?
Both of my teams.
It's just, I don't feel as though it's a right fit for him. Like, I don't believe you can really just like plop them there. Like, look at Indianapolis. They're going to have a new quarterback. It's everything's new. So you're really going to be looking for Julio. I don't know if I want to put all my chips on Julio. That's just my opinion.
They don't even put all their chips in on passing the ball. So it works. He can make an argument. He can get him a cool 1,200. And at the end of the day, we banking on Carson Wentz to be MVP Carson Wentz? I don't believe so.
Are we banking on him to stay healthy, though? That's my thing with it.
Now, that's the question. Health is a concern. Health is 100% a concern that you can't predict right now. But I'm not looking for him to be MVP when he is on the field. But I'm going to tell you right now, with Julio Jones, he's going to be a lot better. He's going to be a lot better than whatever he would be with Michael Pittman. And that's no disrespect. That's all praise to Jones.
Mm-hmm. That's a fact. I give you that one, but I don't know about the Green Bay one. You don't even know who gonna be a quarterback. Julio wants a winner.
If you trade Jordan Love, it's Aaron Rodgers. You give him Jordan Love, it's Rodgers. You think Julio Jones ain't gonna make Rodgers stay? He's gonna sit there and play with Julio and Devontae Adams while trading Jordan Love and telling him, "Hey, I value." I'm trying not to get too much away. We're about to talk about. But Jordan Love is gone. Jordan Love does not leave if Aaron Rodgers is not guaranteed to stay.
I don't know if people want Jordan Love.
I mean, who knows? He was a first-round pick last year. They traded up for him, but he would have been a first-round pick.
They surely scared to lose Rodgers, so they surely don't want Jordan Love.
Come on now. That ain't about Jordan Love, you know. That's about Rodgers winning the MVP.
If Jordan Love was balling in practice, I promise you they'd be making trade offers.
No.
With Aaron Rodgers.
To trade the reigning MVP of the NFL? You think they're in a rush just because the rookie looked good?
James Harden was gone.
A-Rod said that they were trying to push for that anyway before he had that MVP season. So,
I'm going to go ahead and cut this off.
Yeah, let's go to the next segment. We'll talk about this
in the next segment. So y'all make sure y'all stay tuned for SOS Discussion throughout the whole week, because we got bangers every single day. But that's all we got on Julio Jones, not Aaron Rodgers. But y'all tell us what y'all think. Where should Julio Jones go for next season? We'll see y'all next time. SOS Discussion.